Hey there. Welcome to Life Noggin. When you picture allergies, you may imagine someone sneezing, coughing, and itching on a beautiful spring day. Or perhaps you think of someone accidentally eating peanuts or shellfish and going into anaphylactic shock. Whatever the case may be, allergies are a serious problem for millions of people. But how and why do they develop? And what's so different between allergies to pollen or dust and allergies to bee stings or soy? Well, let's start with what these different types of allergies have in common. Your immune system. When an allergen makes contact with the surface on or in your body, nearby immune cells act quickly to destroy the allergen. The cell then covers itself in broken pieces of the allergen and moves to a site of some lymph tissue. When it gets there, it passes pieces of the allergen onto even more immune cells so that they can work together to form an antibody called immunoglobulin E, which definitely sounds like a monster from D&D. If the body comes into contact with the allergen again, these antibodies, which are proteins designed to attach to foreign substances and remove them from your body, will start a reaction to fight against it. First, they activate a part of the immune system called a MAST cell, which then expels a lot of chemicals, like histamines. When histamines are released, they make your capillaries, the smallest blood vessels in your body, more permeable, which allows white blood cells to enter the capillaries and fight the allergens. However, increased permeability doesn't just let white blood cells in. It also lets fluids out, causing the watery eyes and runny nose that you know and love. I'm not crying, I swear, it's just allergies. And similarly, a congested nose is caused by the capillaries growing larger due to the increased permeability. So that covers how you get allergies. But what about why? Why would your body turn against itself like that? And why are some allergies just annoying while others are deadly? For many years, the prevailing idea was that the immune system perceived allergens as being similar to parasitic worms, and for that reason, it would unleash the same attack on a peanut as it would on a tapeworm. Parasitic worms are a serious threat, but they are less prevalent than they were in the lives of our ancestors, which explains why immunoglobulin E would choose to attack allergens in the absence of worms. A similar theory says that allergens may have posed a real threat to us many years ago. According to Dr. Kate Welch, a specialist in immunology and allergies, it's possible that our ancestors were in serious danger when they encountered something like pollen. Therefore, our immune systems are kicked into gear when they make contact with these allergens, even though we evolved and pollen isn't really a big threat anymore. Welch claims that it's even possible that allergic reactions are important because they may warn us to get out of a dangerous area, say, directly under a wasp nest. Seriously, get away from there. Finally, another theory has come to light recently, and it claims that allergens are actually more dangerous than we might have known. Several researchers have conducted a study in which they injected mice with an allergen found in bee venom called PLA2, which rips cell membranes apart. They found that immunoglobulin E didn't react to the PLA2 until it started hurting cells. So when you cough or your nose runs, this study suggests that it's because your immune system is trying to get dangerous allergens out of your body. And when it comes to life-threatening allergies, they're simply a more overactive version of the same response. So don't let your sneezing bother you too much. Your immune system is doing you a big favor. My immune system is actually my animator, and he saves me from stuff all the time. Right, animator? Can you save me? Hello? So are you allergic to anything? Let us know in the comment section below, or tell us, what should we talk about next? We're taking suggestions for future videos. Did you know that Life Noggin has another channel called Play Noggin? We explore the science found in some of your favorite video games. Check out the video we did on Splatoon 2 and what the ink is really made of.
When your inkling's not grossed out, swimming through ink also gives them cover by hiding them from the enemy. For actual squids, it's not so different. Their ink sacs open up right by a funnel that can push water through. When a squid is threatened by a predator, they can dump the ink into the stream of water, shrouding them while they find a place to hide.
My name is Blocko. This has been Life Noggin. Don't forget to keep on thinking.